All right, so this is one of those good learning experiences. This is not going to work. So what do you do?
Well,
it's just my nature to figure out another way around it. So that's what I'm going to do. And while I was looking for a solution to this issue, I found one of those corner pieces I was talking about. So this is one of those tri-corner pieces. So it's got a bolt that goes in this way, and this way. This is one that I got off of their 8020 store. It's completely unfinished. Still has the CNC lines in it. It's not chamfered or anything. And they probably scrapped it because of that. So a drill or something hit it and marred it and made it a defect. So I probably got it for next to nothing. But this piece happens to be threaded. So what this would allow you to do is connect a piece this way, and this way. So that's why those screw heads have to be so shallow, so that when it sinks in, you can get the other screw in the other direction, like so. So anyway, those are pretty cool. I've used them to make an enclosure before for the mini CNC. So enough of that. So how do we fix this? Well, in the back should be fine. I can get to those screws. It's not an issue. Got some grease on the table from the ball screw, slinging grease around. So I have two options actually. I can use those 45 brackets or I can use these 45 brackets. The shelf that this is sitting on is really taking the downward load. All I need to do is maintain its position, so I can easily come in and do the brackets like this, or if I really want to beef it up, I can do the brackets like that. And that is how we're going to fix that. So what I need to do now, the ball screw is basically locked in. Everything's good there. What I have to do now is make sure that the distance, what I typically do is make sure that the distance from one inside rail to the inside of this is the same front to back. That way I know I pretty much got it at least parallel to the side pieces, so that the screw doesn't get in a bind as it's traversing the bridge front to back. So all I need to do is put in some T-nuts here and hook these in. And I'm sure I can get away with using these. But I kind of like the added protection, the added stiffness of that. So I'll probably use those anyway. So that's what we're going to do. I'll go ahead and button this up. And I'll show you how I'm going to align it inside inside of the frame. Luckily, 8020 has a lot of tricks up their sleeve. And it's going to help me get out of this problem. And luckily I had what I needed in my goodie bag. So what we have here is I've got to put new T-nuts on the inside of this track on this side and this side of the actuator. Now these can only go in from the end, like so, like you've seen me do countless times. Even the heavy duty ones, they have to go in from the end. Well, 8020 has something called a drop-in T-nut, and they come in a couple of different flavors. This one actually has a small little set screw that's here next to the hole, and you can roll those in. Don't make a liar out of me. You can roll those in like so. That look like magic. And then these actually allow you to lock down that set screw, and so that way the T-nut is now captive. It just stays put. So if you've got something you got to take apart a lot, to tell you, there's not much that's more frustrating than putting a T-nut in there like on its side. If I was doing something on the inside of the rail and trying to get those threads to mesh, shooting a screw in from the side, sometimes even up and down is a problem, because since the bottom of the track is concave, the T-nut wants to sit on one side or the other. Inside there like that, it'll get kind of cockeyed, and you really need to be coming at it straight on in order to catch those threads. So that can be frustrating. It can take extra time. If I had known what I know now, these economy T-nuts that are floating inside the rail right here that the top actually bolts to, I would have used the ones with the set screws, because then I could put them in there one time and I could be done with it and not have to fish around with them. But I've got some little witness lines that I put down inside the track, so I kind of roughly know where they need to go. and I can usually get them to mate up with a little bit of screwdriver work. So for this inside of this track, so I can pick up the 45 bracket that I'm going to be using, or the 90 bracket, 45 this way, 90 that way. I'm going to use this roll-in T-nut, and it has this little stem on it, so you can kind of hold it like so, and it'll hold it in position, but that stem will get in the way. So what you can do is you can just pull that out, and that leaves the T-nut inside the track. And I'll still have to fish around with it, but since this is pretty open where I'm going to be working, it's not going to be an issue. So these are a lot more expensive than the economy T-nuts are the way to go. I think they're usually about $5.25 or so for 25 of them. These guys are usually like $19 for 25 of them. And this is all on their eBay store. And then the roll-in ones, I don't know how much those are, but they're pricey. So luckily I had just enough. I had four of them in my grab bag, and that's exactly what I need. So we'll go ahead and tie this in and at least get the screw started so I can kind of float it around, and then I'll use my little alignment fixture or little alignment gauge to make sure it's parallel with the far side of the machine.